Hello, everybody. It is time for Rediscover Your Stamps with my good friend Hiba from My Little Journal. We're going to be using this adorable stamp set from Studio Calico. I'm going to be working with Midnight Hot Tub Rose Petals and Pink Champagne Ink from Catherine Pooler. I have these two adorable photos of my niece. We're just going to scrapbook one of them today. And then I have some fun plaid paper, which is also from Catherine Pooler. It perfectly matches the ink colors I've already chosen, which I love. I am still working in my Pocket Page notebook from the stamp spot, and I am just trimming down some paper. This is just 8.5, maybe like 65 pound cardstock, nothing special, and I don't want it to be too thick. I want it to be something with a smaller weight. I'm trimming it down to 4 by 8.25 because I know that that will fit into my pockets perfectly. I'm gonna fill the pockets today. What I wanna do here is I wanna use the stamp set and I wanna kind of create a repeating pattern. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the stamp set from Studio Calico and I'm going to lay the stamps out that I want to use upside down on my Misti. I use my Misti as a tool, not just as a stamp platform. I use it for a lot of different things when I'm stamping. And this is one of them. So I'm gonna lay these stamps out exactly the way I want them to be on my page, all kind of clustered together. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna actually grab the stamps all together with an acrylic block, keeping them nice and straight. And now I can go ahead and kind of burnish them on my arm. Everybody always asks me why I do this. So you will find that most stampers, when they're using a stamp set for the first time, they'll use an eraser or they'll stamp it off onto a piece of paper. There's lots of different ways you can do this, but the idea is to just get the oils from the manufacturing of the stamp off of the stamp. And it gives you a really kind of much better impression. Kind of seasons the stamp up a little bit. I just rub it on my arm. I've always done that, so that's what I'll keep doing. But if you use an eraser or whatever your technique for doing it is fine. It all accomplishes the same thing. So I grab the pad out of the bottom of my Misti, and I'm going to use that as something to stamp on top of. And now I can just take my three colors of ink. I'm going to create a repeating pattern from the top to the bottom of my paper, creating my own kind of pattern on the paper with the repeated stamping. I started with Pink Champagne, and now I'm moving on to Rose Petals. You can kind of see how I'm watching the top, make sure I'm lining these up, and then for the next set of stamping, I'm going to offset them. So I don't want these stamps to be in a row. I want them to kind of move about the page. So this is how I'm going to get that. So I'm doing Pink Champagne, then Rose Petal, then Hot Tub, and then back to the Pink Champagne. And then I'm just washing my stamps off with a baby wipe in between. I'm going all the way down to the bottom. I need a little bit of my head to show. I'm so sorry, but I need to be able to get these nice and straight. And that's probably the hardest part with doing repeat stamping, is to make sure that those stamps are nice and straight. So I'm just going to move my paper up and go in with the Hot Tub at the end. And I wanted to, I want this to look like a continuous pattern. So when I stamped at the top, I made sure that the stamps were a little bit off the edge of the page. And now that I'm stamping at the bottom, I'm making sure that my last set of stamps is also off the edge of the page. And I think this turns out really, really cute. This is just a fun way to use your stamps to create your own kind of pattern. And this also allows me to use a lot of the stamps that are in this stamp set. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to slip that repeating pattern paper into the pocket, and that will become one side of my traveler's notebook spread. And then I cut two sheets of paper so I could slip the other one into the back side for another day with the extra photo. So what I want to do next is I want to trim my photo a little bit. I decided I wanted a square photo instead of a rectangle. This photo is 3x4, so I'm just trimming it down to 3x3. And then I'm going to take this pretty pink plaid paper and I'm going to cut it down to about 3¼ by 3¼, which is going to give me a nice mat around my photo. I'm gonna grab my old school Creative Memories heart punch from my stash and we're gonna put it to use today. How about that? So I'm gonna go ahead and just punch. I think I punched 5 hearts. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna center my photo and then I'm gonna go ahead and kind of place the hearts around the top and bottom of my photo. My niece is wearing this black outfit in this photo, and so I really wanted to add some pops of black around my spread to kind of coordinate and to go with the photo. And also because I really, really just like a touch of black, just a touch. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some more of those stamps that I haven't used yet from the stamp set. I'm going to stamp them using Midnight Ink from Catherine Pooler, and I'm stamping them onto the plaid paper, and then I can fussy cut them out and create a couple of additional embellishments for my spread. Whenever I create my projects for this particular video series, I always want to use as many of the stamps as I possibly can from that stamp set. I really want to get as much ink on that stamp set as possible, and I think I did pretty good with this one this week. This little triangle stamp set that I'm stamping right now says something about giving me all the cozy vibes. And then there is actually the word cozy that fits within that stamp set. So after I stamped in black, I'm gonna come back in with that word cozy and stamp that in the rose petal stamp set, which will give me this like really cool embellishment. I think it turned out really, I love this. This was a great stamp set to work with this month. I really, really like it. And now, thanks to Hiba, I've discovered Studio Calico stamps. I've never really shopped at their site. And now I'm totally hooked and they have fabulous stamps. This specific one was designed by Anna Creative Bubble and it is so good. It has so many pretty sayings and just really fun stamp set. I really love it. And now I have like 3 more in my cart at Studio Calico. Anyway, that's just what I need, right? And somewhere else to buy stamps because I don't already have enough. That's okay though, because these are really awesome stamps and I do use my stamps. I never regret buying stamp sets because I am a big stamper. I use them quite often. So, but I digress. Let me return back to my project here. I am creating kind of like a diagonal line. I'm starting with the hearts that I've punched. And now I'm going to go ahead and grab my scissors and fussy cut those stamped elements. I'm going to place the one that says Happy Moments right under my photo. And then that connects my title. I'm going to do the cozy one up at the top. And then I have the one that says Simple Pleasures at the bottom. And the one that Simple Pleasures one at the bottom, I let it kind of hang off of the edge. And now I want to add just a little bit more black. Just a smidgen more. And in this stamp set is this teeny tiny little heart that is so cute. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my smallest stamp block and my Catherine Pooler Midnight Ink. And I am going to scatter some of these cute black hearts to kind of reinforce the diagonal design. And that is where we're gonna call this spread done. Be sure to head over and check out Hiba's video on her channel. I'm sure she did something amazing. And if this stamp set is still in stock, I will link it up for you below along with her channel. Have a wonderful day, guys. Bye.